amicable to everyone and recognizing that not everyone is the same and every single person is different, but you have to have a plan that addresses one's needs and requirements of the people you are to serve. So I think this is one of the problems we suffer from. We want to be leaders, but we don't have a written plan, an agenda to work to, without which you can't achieve anything because you simply go around in circles. You need to have, a good leader will always have an immediate, short, medium, and long-term objective in everything that he or she does. Because if you don't have an end game in mind, then you can never really move to the levels you intend to, simply because you don't have a working plan. If you go down into the City of London, and I happen to have the good fortune of doing so every day, you will find that the major corporations, every single one of them, have, for their management structure, a plan of action that the manager of the particular business have to work to every single day. And if he or she deviates from it, then you will find that the head office will come down on them and force them back onto the path that they have chosen because they spend lots of money researching their ideas and they have a clear goal in mind. And if any employee deviates from it, then they bring them back. So as a community, what we're lacking and what most leaderships in our community lack is clear vision, a written plan, an organized body around them that knows that when he or she delegates, they expect a result within a given time frame. Those are the qualities that I believe good leaders should have. You must be able to delegate, you must be able to have timelines by which each delegated responsibility is completed by. And you must also have what is called a managerial working plan to enable all the people who are in your team, just like a football team, all the players know what the manager expects from them. If they don't go out there and play around when they're on the field, they know they're going to score and win. And they also know that the defenders don't act like the forward players. They all have their role, and particular aspects of the team is played out by each individual player. So, in order for anything to be successful, you have to build managers and leaders, build teams around them. And the team knows their particular role. So you will never find the accountant trying to be the lawyer in the team because he or she knows that if they go beyond the scope of their particular remit, then the problem will be that you have confusion within the team. So I think particularly, a good leader will always have a good team around him or her and is organized in a way that enables people to see clearly what he or she is trying to do and what to achieve so that you have an end game result. And it's usually in those circumstances win-win. Even if you or someone looking in don't see what you perceive as not a win, they know they've won because they've achieved their targets, their goals, their objectives. That's good leadership, I think.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, rise up, family.
Rise up.
Him said, a true leader delivers service and provision to his people. If a one who calls himself a leader can do that, he's not powerful, he's pitiful. So you can look on certain things out there. Marcus Garvey said to him, he said, any leader if it depends on another race for the development of his people, the leader that is setting you up to fail. Right. So you see, there's a big difference between a farmer and a farmer. You understand? A farmer know what to plant, but a farmer just take instruction and plant what he has been given.
Oh, who said that?
Yes, very interesting comments there from the panelists and the audience members who have spoken so far. Just for me to focus on the question as a leader, how do you inspire a successful organization? And I would home in on two words there, which is inspire and leadership, because those are the words that for me underpin that entire statement. First to look at inspire, which means to you are filling someone with an urge or the ability to do something or to feel something, to feel what you're feeling. so that that person becomes part of your vision, that person is seeing along the plan that you have, and you're breathing life into their action. Because quite often you have, a leader might have a number of people around them, but they might lack enthusiasm. You know, they might be passionate, but they might not be inspired, and it's not very, it's not a good combination, because it's not one of the same. So, to be inspired to act, because to be inspired means to know what to do, that you understand the vision that the leader poses. And also success is obviously is about attaining a specific goal. And I think that if a person is inspired, a good leader would inspire an organization or the people within the organization to see the goal that he wants. He has to be able to, they have to be able to envision the success that he sees. Because if they can't see that, then for me, it's on to a loser, because there is a huge chasm between the leader and the people who are around him, who are supposed to help him achieve that particular goal. But in focusing on the play as it relates to the question, as a good leader, how do you inspire an organization? I think that, first of all, I think that the Prime Minister was a dictatorial leader, but for the wrong reasons. I think because there were a lot of issues there that he was not managing there. There was a conflation between his personal life and his role as Prime Minister. To me, he seemed quite utterly confused as to whether he was running the country or whether he had difficulties managing the relationships around him and how it impacted on his job as Prime Minister. So in my mind, he wasn't clear on that. I think he was a bit muddled. I think perhaps he allowed the emotional side of things to get in the way, because he got emotional right the way through, from the beginning until the end. It was all emotive. Emotion took over. It was not clear and decisive there. And that was my view on that particular thing. But in terms of getting to the audience response, I think that is at the back of it. I did mention about the clarity of vision. And I think that is utterly important. And I think that the Prime Minister kind of missed that on the reason why he was there, not quite sure the focus on his vision, because he should have been there to lead direction. And also in the way that he communicated what he wanted done. I wasn't clear as to why, because he didn't communicate clearly why he was having a, because I didn't understand why he was having to go at the Deputy Prime Minister, because I didn't know what she has done. And Malcolm's situation was even more ambiguous. He just sacked him on the spot. So, again, he wasn't very effective communicator there. And that relates to what Menti said as well about being able to communicate that vision quite clearly and succinctly. So a good leader has to have that. But coming back to John Canoe, he didn't mention the issue of race in a particular context, but I have to disagree with him here. The reason for that is that I didn't think that, in my view, that that issue impacted on his time of leadership. I didn't think it wouldn't matter what colleague he was married to. I didn't think that was the issue there, in my view, and in terms of leadership. I didn't think that had absolutely anything to do with that. Maybe it might be in other matters, but in this particular situation, in terms of leadership, I didn't think it had absolutely nothing to do with it. I think race was absolutely relevant in this context. So in closing, I think that a leader has to be able to articulate the vision so it resonates with those he wants to inspire. Thank you.
Okay, I'm going to be brief, because I think most of what I was going to say has been said. I'll keep it brief. The important word in the question is inspire. That's what we're talking about here. I mean, some people have sidetracked and got off a bit. But what inspires you? What in a leader inspires you? I mean, we look at certain people and they inspire us. Muhammad Ali inspired a lot of people. Marcus Garvey inspired a lot of people. Why? That's what you need to ask yourself. What quality has that individual got that inspires me? they obviously have reached out to you in some way that you understand. So a team leader, I've got a few things I've written down there, has to make people believe in him or her. Okay? If you don't believe in somebody, you're not going to be inspired by them, and you're not going to follow them. Okay? So it's very important that you believe. And also, there's a very important thing that we must always remember, that if you're a team leader, you need to have trust in your team. If you don't trust your team, or your team has no trust in you, then it's not going to work. It's a failure. So I believe that to be a good leader, you need to get your team to believe in you and trust you. And also, you need to be able to, in times of things going wrong, be able to think on your feet and react immediately. Because if you stumble when things go wrong, people lose faith in you. So that's a very, very important quality. I think, as an audience, I think tonight you've probably been one of the best, because I mean everybody I think has latched on to what questions were pertaining to. So give yourselves a big round of applause. And that's me. Thank you.
Okay, we have, the evaluator has evaluated all the speakers, and we have two winners. In second place, we have Kim. Kim?
Hooray! Come on, Kim.
Not physical.
No,
she can't. She can't. No.
Oh, I'll come to you.
Let it come to her.
Okay. You've got two tickets to perform it from the ACLC on the 8th of November.
Fantastic. Well, thank you.
And our first prize goes to Lyndon.
Where's Lyndon?
Lyndon.
Good. Oh, thank you. Yes, Linda. A veteran. Save some for me, Linda. You're in your family.
Okay. Well, that's a shocker.
Yeah.
But I am grateful. If anything, what the Speakers Club has managed to do, as far as I'm concerned, is to teach us that we are all leaders, or at least we have the potential to be. And the plays, I came in a bit late on the first one, but I did get some of it, but especially the second one, has pointed out how you can not be inspired by whomever call himself a leader that doesn't know what a leader isn't.
Yay, fantastic.
Yeah. Okay, if you go and get your tickets afterwards, we're going to pull out the raffle. I've got my helper here, Ebony's going to pull out the winning ticket. Pull out the winning ticket for me.
Jason. Yes, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for everybody who's turned out. You know, it's always appreciated. And obviously, you've heard, if anyone who hasn't heard, Hitman died, I think it was yesterday. So, anyone who don't know, obviously, they don't know, you know. Jan, time is coming. We can't see you, though. Can't see you, Jan. Where are you there? Yeah, time is coming. Come in the room, man. Right, Jan, what we're going to do, we're going to start off with a cappella first. And then we're going to go into the songs, yeah? And it's funny, ladies and gentlemen, this is the song that I wrote, and Hitman was supposed to do an interview, and I was supposed to bring this song along, so he didn't even get to hear it, right? So it's called Living Love, yeah? It's a cappella. Here we go. Look at all the pain. To see my people suffering, it's such a shame. Yes, it makes me want to cry. Heads of state and governments, they turn a blind eye. Oh yes, people are fighting and killing and using and abusing. It's all around me, it's everywhere I go. Whoa, whoa, why do things have to be this way? Can't we all try to make a change? Chorus. Said the world can be a beautiful place if we live in love. Give me the first track, Tom Thomas. Thank you. Doggy fresh. Come on in. First track, the jam. Da 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 da. Yeah. Sorry, guys. That's the thing. You see what things is like, and you never know what's gonna happen. That's the beauty of it.
You have to emphasize. You have to with impromptu. You have to do what this a cappella look like in a virgin.
Sorry, guys. Can't keep the people waiting.
Jumping up and doing a cappella.
Right, what I'm gonna do in the meantime is just do another song.
Do a cappella.
So
don't lose the energy vibes.
Right. Tell me why the good I am. All the killing and the suffering ain't no fun. Tell me why the good I am. All the killing and the suffering ain't no fun. No, no, no. Don't hang on those street corners, wasting precious time. You man, we don't understand the level of destruction we cause ourselves by messing with this world. Tell me why the good I am. All the killing and the suffering, it ain't no fun. Listen. Too many mothers crying, too many children dying. We should stop pretending and find a way. Yeah.